In today's Number Corner lesson, we will be introducing the game Splat. Take a moment to look over my Splat grid page in silence. Now let's review the information in the key and spend a few minutes determining the area of the entire grid. Keys are used to help us understand what the symbols and charts mean. Sometimes keys are also called legends. This key says that each black line is equal to 10. So a vertical line and a horizontal line represents 10 by 10, which would be 100. Now take a moment and figure out what this entire grid area would be. How many lines are going up the side? How many lines are going across the top? Count them up and then write an equation to show what you determined. I got 60 times 80, or 80 times 60. Because, remember, multiplication can go backwards and forwards. Order doesn't matter when we multiply because of the commutative property. Another way to think about this problem is like this. 6 times 8 times 100. Because we know there are 6 lines going up the side, 8 lines going across, and we know from the key that every little box in the grid represents 100. What's 6 times 8? Yes, 48! There's a total of 48 squares in this grid, but we know that our answer has got to be more, a lot more, since each small square is a 10 by 10, not a 1 by 1. It represents 100. So this is really what this grid means. That means the area of each small square is 100. There are 48 small squares, so 48 times 100 is what this grid is showing us. 60 times 80 equals 4,800. I want to show you another way to write this equation, or to think about this problem. There are different ways to write any number, and one way is to write 60 is 6 times 10, and you can also write 80 as 8 times 10. And we have done this before. When you're multiplying numbers, the commutative property lets us change the order of those numbers, and the associative property lets us multiply them in different ways. So we see 6 times 8 and 10. Well, 6 times 8 and then times 10. That gives us 48 times 100 with a product of 4,800. That's right. Now determine the area of this grid. How many down? How many across? Write an equation to help you. Remember that each small square represents 10 by 10, so every small box is equivalent to 100. Some of you are thinking 20 times 20 is 400. What else? Other ways to do this? What about 20 times 20 is 400, or what about 2 times 2 times 100 is 400, because it was a 2 by 2 square and each square is worth 100. Comment with another way you determined the area of this grid. Determine the area of this grid now. Use the same methods we've been practicing and discussing in the previous two. What equation could we write? Pause the video if you need more time, and then come back to check your answers. The better you get with this, the more fun you will have later in the lesson with our game Splat. A 40 by 50 grid would be 40 times 50, and we know that 4 times 5 is 20. Factor in our 100s boxes, that makes it 2,000. Okay, last one to practice on your own. Pause the video once you've solved it, and then check your answer. When you look at the rectangle, you see the number of squares on each side. You multiply those together and then multiply 100 because each small square has an area of 100. There were 5 down and 7 across, so 50 by 70 to multiply together. I know that 5 7 times is 35, and we add the 2 zero digits to make it 3,500. As the area of this grid. Make some generalizations about how to find the area of any square or rectangle on the grid and share in the comments below. We will use what we just discussed as we play Splat together as a class. Turn to the Splat grid and the Splat record sheet in your own number corner student book. You're also going to need a paperclip or two paperclips so that you can have spinners on your spin sheet. So, how to play? One, teams or players take turns spinning the two spinners. Two, teams or players multiply their two numbers together and record the product. Three, if a team spins Splat, broken egg, they get a zero for that turn. Four, if a team spins two Splats in a single turn, they get a zero for the entire round. This is called Splat. Five, if a team thinks that the other team multiplied incorrectly, they can challenge them. Six, if the team did multiply incorrectly, they lose their points for that turn. Seven, each team gets four turns to spin, multiply, and record the product. Each group of four turns is a single round. And you can see that from the grid there on the record sheet. After each round, teams add their products from their four turns and record the sum. After the two rounds, teams or players add their sums from both rounds. And whoever has the higher sum wins the game. Okay, who's ready to play?